Innovation is the cornerstone of success in America. In order to compete in the global marketplace, businesses and individuals are continuously striving to stay ahead of the game. I'm Terry Bradshaw. You know, from emerging technologies and financial strategies to the latest healthcare developments, you would be surprised by the many factors coming into play. Welcome to Today in America. Once a thriving steel mill that at one time turned out nearly half of Canada's steel production, the Sydney Tar Ponds are now a hazardous waste site. With the tar ponds forming a tidal estuary at the mouth of a freshwater stream emptying into the harbor, and thousands of nearby residents concerned for their health, efforts to remediate the site have been long overdue.
Well, say, having been involved in the project now for over 20 years, I mean, there's always was concern that the project was lagging and taking quite a while to get going. But I can confidently say that I've never seen a project with more technical study done and a high level of public consultation to get the project going.
The Sydney Tar Ponds Agency is responsible for implementing the largest active remediation project in Canada, the Sydney Tar Ponds and Coke Ovens cleanup.
The contaminants in the tar ponds are being remediated through the use of solidification stabilization. One of the challenges of using solidification stabilization in a watershed is managing the water. Not only are we open to the harbor here, but there are two urban brooks that feed into the ponds that are being treated.
In order to help manage and collect the urban water, the agency built two pumping stations to drain into outlet structures before releasing the water back into the Sydney Harbor. The system is designed to pump up to a 1-in-5-year storm, allowing extra water to flow into the ponds when necessary to prevent the brooks from flooding. The agency's biggest challenge is remediating a hazardous waste site within a large urban area. Consequently, the Sydney Tar Ponds Agency designed a comprehensive multi-million-dollar air and odor monitoring program that monitors air along the fence line in real time, in addition to a series of ambient air stations located throughout the community.
Our experience in the South Pond last year has taught us that there are no health issues with reference to odor. However, there is inconvenience, and we have put a program together to address this so we're not inconveniencing our neighbors.
In order to minimize their impact on the environment while mixing cement, workers on site manage dust by creating a curtain of water as a barrier. The agency has a budget for the amount of dust that can be created each day and requires the operation shut down should it be exceeded.
Environmental protection plans provide the framework for the contractor to price, plan, and perform their day-to-day duties here on site. They also make sure that we adhere to, and the contractors adhere to, the specific regulations and guidelines that are applied here to site to ensure that we protect human health and ecology at all times.
As part of the remediation efforts, the Sydney Tar Ponds Agency believes keeping in touch with the community is key. The agency conducts monthly meetings to discuss the project with a community liaison committee and resident tours.
Beyond improving the environment for the people of Sydney, the project has helped build a stronger economy by ensuring that the local people are being hired, local businesses and contractors are benefiting from the contracts of the project. As well, we're reaching out into the community with initiatives for our First Nations, for our African Nova Scotians, and women.
The Sydney Tar Ponds Agency was established as a single-purpose agency to deal with just the Tar Ponds project, and the agency will cease to exist in 2014 at the completion of the project. But the skills that are being learned by the people involved will be used in other projects and are being used in other projects now.